Hi, this is Brandon with ChiroUp. I want to talk about patient accountability today. And the reason I want to talk about patient accountability is because I'm a problem solver, just like you are in practice. I want to make sure that I can solve someone's problem and I can provide a realistic pathway to get them out of pain. One stumbling block that I've seen in my last, 10 years in practice is that the word arthritis always trips me up. And the reason it trips me up is because I know and you know there's nothing you can do to take away arthritis. So that's always one of those things that patients are like, well, I've got arthritis and that's the cause of my pain. And we know from the literature, we know from all the stuff that's came out is that arthritis is maybe correlated to pain, but it's not the cause of their pain. However, later on in life, when that arthritis gets worse and worse and worse, that correlation gets stronger and stronger. So what can we do to prevent arthritis from getting worse? Wang et al. Put out a great paper in the Spine Journal that says, move. It's one of those cheap and easy things that we can do for ourselves and we can do for our patients and teach them the importance of how to move well and move often. I would highly recommend when you have somebody with arthritis is blaming that for causing their pain on a regular basis to educate them on the importance of movement. More so, provide a rehab program, provide the ability for that person to move in their office. So frequently I hear, I've got to work, I've got to sit at my desk for 8 hours and work at a computer. What can I do? You know, I have to work. And I get that. So do I, so do you. However, ask for 30 seconds, ask for 50 seconds out of every hour to do some rehab exercises. Now that's going to be somewhat dependent on you're comfortable, as far as prescribing those and what the patient's comfortable doing at work. However, make it easy. Make it something that they don't need an elliptical next to their desk. They don't need any kind of weights or resistance bands. Find some body weight movements that they can stand up and do at their desk. For example, when I have somebody with extension directional preference, or I have somebody with stenosis, in fact, stenosis is a great example, I have them do a standing knee to chest exercise that they're gonna do at their desk once an hour, just 10 times per side. I'm asking for literally 30 seconds out of their hour to get them moving, provide some more range of motion to their back. This is going to be one of those life-changing things. Not only is it going to help prevent arthritis from what we know from this recent paper, but it's also going to get them up and get them feeling better. Helps them think about their condition on a regular basis and helps them get themselves out of pain. It's providing one avenue to help themselves and not so much depend on other people to get them out of pain or other chemicals or drugs or practitioners to help with that process. Making patients accountable is one of those things that gets me up in the morning. I love empowering patients to make sure they understand their condition, I understand their condition, and we have a common pathway to get them out of pain. In ChiroUp, we've done this through our patient education and our rehab programs. We've just changed the lay condition and the lay descriptor for degeneration to help patients understand that it's not only that car accident they had or the time they fell out of the tree or their birthing trauma that caused their arthritis. It's actually the things they're doing to themselves. And we're going to provide a pathway to get themselves out of pain and not just complain about things that happened in the past. Thanks.